school at about 9, and the kids are already in class, but they are all peeking their heads out of the doors and windows, waving. So it took a little bit for us to get organized, but then we walked in little groups down to the beach, and we all got them each trash bags, and we went along the beach and cleaned up trash along the beach.
The garbage cleanup went really well with my class, especially because it was really chaotic at first, and then the classes would stay together in their own groups, and they're just going everywhere and playing in the water. But my group actually, like, once I got all together, they stayed together and shared a bag.
Some kids were really great, trying to get the most. There's a lot of trash that you don't always see kind of more pushed to the back, so I think we made an impact on the community helping that up, or even if just other people saw the kids cleaning up trash, maybe that would help them or make them think to throw their trash away.
And we went to the other side of the beach, like not where everybody else went, so where all the people were, so there's more trash over there. And so we went down to the beach, walked across, and came back up, and they all got really excited, like, oh, Azora, you know, trash, I get. But they did really good.
It's called Lado, ice cream in Spanish. And they were so
when we first get to the school, usually the kids run out of the classroom and jump on you because they're so excited to see you, even though they don't even know you. But they know that when the volunteers come, that we bring arts and crafts, goodies, bracelets, glitter glue, things that they don't see a lot of. And they're always, always so excited to see our group. And when we leave, sometimes it's kind of emotional. Some people cry, and you know, some people are kind of heartbroken for a while because you get really connected to the kids really, really fast. And the more time that you spend here, the more so that's the case.
I mean, it's just crazy. I didn't want to cry, but, you know, I kind of did.
God, that was just... I was trying to avoid it, you know, just denying that, you know, we were leaving because I'm so sad. I'm quick to cry in those moments. And that was just really hard because, you know, even though we're with them a couple of days, we still get really attached and you get your favorites and you spend time with them and they're just the best part of the whole experience.
They got this and that with the rattle of tactics. Then one, two, man, what you gonna do? Bad news, misuse. Give me some truth, you got too much to lose. Who's all your people? Anyway, okay, whatever you say. Wrong or resolute, but in the mood to obey. Station to station, desensitizing the nation. Where all the good people go?
At about 2-ish, 1:32, we piled into two vans, one van and then one open back truck, which the boys rode on, which I didn't know. So we went to La Playa Paradise.
Oh, Paradise Cove. Oh my God.
La Playa Paraíso that we went to, that was just something that you read about in books and see in movies about excluded, you know, virgin beaches that, you know, no one really knows about and are just in the cut. That was just an amazing experience. I've never been to a beach like that.
I think the thing that hit me was we're on top of that flatbed truck and we're driving down this rugged road and all of a sudden there's these two mountains that just split apart. And you see in the valley this just blue ocean. And you keep going down and it's just waves and some kids are playing soccer over there and you look around and there's no one else there. It was really cool to see that we got our own place. We could just choose whatever we wanted, that 2 mile beach.
We walked about 500 meters down to a little area and immediately the first thing I wanted to do was get in the water. We had a barbecue. Armando set up a little fire pit and we had fish, rice, salad, patanos, and watched what could have been sunset with the clouds.
It was a perfect picture of what I envisioned.
envision the coast of Ecuador to look like?
And I was just trying to soak it all in. I couldn't even believe it at times. I was just sitting there looking at the scenery, thinking, wow, I'm here. Like, this is amazing. And like Miklos said, this is what I've been waiting for. But yeah, that was an amazing treat that they were able to share that with us.
Too bad. He became a prisoner of his own past. He stabbed a moment in the back with the round thumbtack that held up the list of things he gotta do. It's really no good. He's moving on before he understood. He shot the future in the foot with every step it took. But from the places that he did, cause he forgot to look. You better staple it together and call it bad weather. 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 If the weather gets better, we should get together. Spend a little time and we could do whatever. And if we get together, we'd be twice as clever. So staple it together and call it bad weather. Good people go. Better staple it together and call it bad.